Hey, Ingo!
Yeah, hey, Chaya.
Do you know what time it is?
Of course, it's time for 5 minutes with Ingo. Today we will talk about linear regression, which is one of the most basic data science and machine learning algorithms available. Some people even claim it's not even machine learning. It's around since about 200 years. Let's not really discuss this now, but hey, you can predict values, so I just treat it as any other machine learning algorithm. So, the idea of linear regression is actually super simple. You have data points in a space and you want to fit those data points with a linear curve, just like the stick here. So let's have a look how this can work. You have a stick and you have a couple of green data points over here, and we would like to get as close to those data points as possible. Well, one way to achieve this is you could take those rubber bands here and connect those rubber bands to those data points, just like I'm doing this right now. And you see those rubber bands, actually they pull the curve, the line around, until it has a stable position. And this is really the basic idea of linear regression. You want to basically fit the linear line as close to the existing data points, or basically, well, minimize the distance between the data points and the linear curve. Okay, let's see how this algorithm works then. So here again, we have our data space, two dimensions. Just for now, we only have like one dimension x at the bottom here, and this is the dimension y we want to predict. Here are our green data points. So for any given position on the x-axis, this line then will tell us what is the corresponding value for y. Well, that's the whole idea of the linear regression curve. Okay, so the curve itself can be described as a formula here. Y is defined as alpha, this is the intercept, the position where it actually crosses the y-axis here, plus beta, which is the slope of the curve, times the value for x. So you probably learned that already like in basic math in school, like many, many years ago. For every single data point, you can make the following calculation, so you can basically calculate the value y I, so this value here, with the same formula, alpha plus the slope beta times xi, the corresponding value. But you see, this is only an approximation, so it's not perfect. So there is some error you're making. We call this epsilon I, so you need to sum this up as well. Those error terms, they are also called residuals. So the algorithm now is super simple. The whole goal is that we actually minimize those residuals, epsilon I. In fact, we want to minimize the sum of all of them. We want to be good for all the data points. Well, instead of just minimizing the sum of the epsilon I, we can also minimize the square of the sum of the squares. So the only thing we can change are the alphas and betas. So this is basically what we can play with. And then for all our existing training data points, we want to minimize the sum of the squared errors. This whole idea is, by the way, called the least squares approach. So now we're doing some mathematical magic. So I'm not going into all the details there, but it's, well, not super, super difficult. And that actually delivers a very surprising result. So we can see that we can calculate the slope better here, just as the correlation coefficient between the values x and y, so that's just the regular Pearson correlation, and then we basically normalize this correlation by this factor here, which is just the standard deviation for y divided by the standard deviation for x. So that is something we can easily calculate. And the intercept alpha is equally easy. After we got the slope beta, we just take the average of all the y's minus beta times the average of all the x's. So now we have our two values, alpha and beta, and with those two values we have basically everything we need to really calculate our linear regression curve. So that's working very easily in one dimension. So what can we do for multiple dimensions? Well, for multiple dimensions it's very similar. It's a simple technique which is called ordinary least squares. You can look it up if you want to know the details, but the basic ideas are pretty much the same. So those are the basics of linear regression.
So, Ingo, are there any pros and cons of linear regression?
Oh, sure. So first of all, the pros. I mean, it's a very fast method typically in terms of number of data points. It's also easy to understand. I mean, all those factors like the slope, if you have multiple x and you have those coefficients which sum up, that actually gives you some idea what is more important and less important for your regression analysis. It's not really great for many dimensions. If you really have a high number of dimensions, techniques like support vector machines, for example, are much better. And also another thing which is problematic are outliers. Outliers can really screw up the curve. I can actually show this easily to you here on the wooden board again. So let's actually go over here. If I have just one more data point, so I was hiding it in the beginning, it's here at the bottom right, and I just add another rubber band, look what happens. It really changes the slope of the curve like big time. So only one data point actually can change the whole slope, the whole regression coefficient. Again, this is something where other regression techniques, like for example support vector machines, are just much better and more robust against outliers. But it's a simple tool. It should be in your tool belt, like knife base, k-nearest neighbors, decision trees. Those are kind of the basic methods you always have in your tool belt, easy to understand, and as such, it's a great method. Thank you for today.